I know.
All right. Thank you, Jesus. Here comes Pastor Ezekiel.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. All right, ushers, let's get in the game. let's just get those strugglers in so we can have church, amen? We are here this morning, gathered in His name, and He never disappoints. He shows up all the time when His people are gathered, amen? Let us go ahead and pray. Father, we thank You for this beautiful day. We thank You that You are here in this place, oh God, Father. Lord, we pray this morning that, Lord, we are sick and tired of church as usual. We want You to infiltrate our services. We want You to come in, Almighty God and Holy Spirit. We want You, oh Father, to come and blow, oh God, through us, oh Father. We need to see the fire of heaven fall in this place this morning, oh God. We need to see hearts change. We need to see bodies healed, Almighty God, in the name of Jesus Christ. You are still a miracle working God, and we still believe on the God of miracles. God, today is the day that Your glory falls in this place, that we feel Your presence and we feel Your touch. Oh Father, as we raise our hearts to You this morning, as our worshipers, oh God, raise their voices to You this morning, Father, let Your glory come. Let Your glory descend. Let it be so thick in this place, God, that, Father, we would know You are here. And the word of the day, oh God, oh, Your servant that You have chosen today to break bread for us today, God, let it be a now word for us. Anoint her, Almighty God, in Jesus' name. Let us hear You speak through her. Let us hear You thunder through her. In the name of Jesus Christ, Father, we thank You and we bless Your holy name. Let's have church.
Yes. Amen. Amen. The Bible says that God dwells in the praises of His people. Woo! I got a story too good to hide. I was a blind man wandering until I saw the light. Yeah, I got a story I can't deny. I'm a living, breathing miracle, and I just gotta testify. Yeah. Ain't nobody love me like Jesus. Ain't nobody love me this good. Ain't nobody love me like Jesus. And I know, nobody good. Tell me You can give me this freedom. Tell me You can get me this far. Ain't nobody love me like Jesus. I know, nobody good. Now I'm anointed to bring the news. Everything He did for me, I know He'll do for you. He gave me joy in the morning, through the ashes a crown. I'm a walking, talking miracle, and I just gotta let it out. Ain't nobody loving like Jesus. Ain't nobody loving this good. Ain't nobody loving like Jesus. I know, nobody good. Tell me You can give me this freedom. Tell me You can get me this far. Ain't nobody loving like Jesus. I know, nobody good. Nobody could pull me from the darkness, save me by the blood, raise me from the ashes. I know, nobody could break off every shackle, tear down every wall, set me free the captive. I know, nobody could break know, I know, nobody could break off every shackle, tear down every wall, set free every captive. I know, nobody could. Nobody love me like Jesus. Ain't nobody love me this good. Ain't nobody love me like Jesus. I know, nobody could. Tell me who could give me this feeling. Tell me who could get me this far. Ain't nobody love me like Jesus. I know, nobody could. Ain't nobody. Nobody love me like you, Jesus.
Ain't nobody. Come on, let's a shout of praise unto the Lord, for He is good. Yes. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father, for this brand new day and this brand new week. We worship you. We worship you, God. We're going to put 3 minutes on the clock, and let's just reach across the aisle, introduce yourself to someone, or high five someone you haven't seen in a while, and we'll come right back for more worship.
Covenant Church, it is an amazing Sunday. Let's all grab our seats as we prepare to continue our worship. In Jesus' name. I'm glad y'all don't like hanging out with each other. I mean, It's so amazing to be part of a church that we just all want. We're all excited to see somebody on a Sunday morning, maybe see somebody we haven't seen in a minute, maybe meet a new friend. I just love that we have a church that just gets out of our seats and says hi and fellowships together. Amen. Come on, Covenant Church. Are y'all happy you got to see somebody this morning? Amen. 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 Bible says we're two or three gathered, so he is there. And he is there this morning, and we thank you for being here. We thank you for choosing Covenant Church. We're going to continue our worship and praise here in a minute, but before we do that, we just want to take a quick second to worship with our tithes and offerings. And as the ushers come forward, we just want to take a minute and set this time aside. You know, tithes for me is important, but it always, somebody preached a word one time on first fruits, on giving God the first thing. And it's so important that we, you know, it's one thing for me to say, okay, I'm going to give God this money, but I'm going to go out and have fun and do this. And then, oh, shoot, I need a little bit of that money. I need a little bit of that. I was going to give God my time for this. I was going to give God my tithe for this. I was going to give God my talent for this, but I ran out because I got too busy doing the things that I prioritize above that. When I give my tithe and offering, I love the text to give, which is going to be right up here behind me, because it says, I'm going to stop everything, and before I do anything else, I'm going to give to God. I'm going to give back to him what he's already given to me. We thank you, Covenant Church, this morning for being here. We thank you for allowing us to be your church this morning. Father God, we thank you for all the blessings you have given us, Lord. We thank you for the opportunity we have, Lord, to sow into something greater, Lord, to be a small part of something so much grander, Lord, that you can do so much more with what we could, Lord. And we thank you for the opportunity, Lord, to give to you. We thank you for the opportunity to worship you this morning. We thank you for the opportunity we have just to be in this building and love you, God. And we pray this all in Jesus' name. Covenant Church, come on, say amen if you love Jesus. Covenant Church, I know the worship team's behind me, and they are ready to sing and praise God. Are y'all ready to sing and praise God? Y'all ready to lift your hands and voices? Come on, stand to our feet. Father God, we thank you for this time, Lord. As we prepare to praise you, Lord, we just pray that you open our hearts and minds, Lord. We receive the words you have today, Lord, but more than anything, Lord, right now, we open our hearts, and may you receive our sound, Lord, the joyful noise we make, Lord, loving you and worshiping you in this place, in Jesus' name.
We worship you, God.
I built up my own name, but the walls couldn't stand. I trusted my own strength, but it was sinking sand. So I put my ruins into your hands and watch you restore them like only you can. If the Lord builds a house, nobody can tear it down. If the Lord builds a house, nobody can tear it down. Fire. But what God holds together, it stands firm every time. So I place my placard on this solid truth, that whatever God's building, no, it won't be moved. Cause if the Lord builds the house, nobody can tear it down. If the Lord builds a house, nobody can tear it down. When it's built on his day, there's nothing gonna shake this ground. If the Lord builds a house, nobody can tear it down. Ooh. for me and my house. We're gonna serve you, Lord. So here's the keys, come on in. Everything we have is yours.
Yes.
As for me and my house, we're gonna serve you, Lord. So here's the keys, won't you come on in. Everything we have is yours. Here's the keys, won't you come on in. Everything we have is yours. The Lord builds a house,
nobody can tear it down. If the Lord builds a house, nobody can tear it down.
When it's built on His name, there's nothing gonna shake this ground. If the Lord builds a house, nobody can tear it down. If the Lord builds a house, nobody can tear it down. If the Lord builds a house, nobody can tear it down. When it's built on His name, there's nothing gonna shake this ground. If the Lord builds a house, nobody can tear it down.
If the Lord builds a house, nobody can tear it down. Woo! Thank you, Jesus. We stand on your word this morning, oh God. No longer I who live, but Christ in me. For I've been born again, my heart is free. The hope of heaven before me, the grave behind. Hallelujah, you brought me back to life.
I won't forget the moment I heard you call my name. Out of the grip of darkness into the light of grace.
Just like Lazarus, oh, you brought me back to life. Where there was dead religion, now there is living faith. All of my hope and freedom are found in Jesus' name. Just like Lazarus, oh, you brought me back to life.
Sing no longer.
No longer I who live, but Christ in me. For I've been born again, my heart is free. The hope of heaven before me, the grave behind. Hallelujah, you brought me back to life. When something says I'm guilty, I'll point to the price you paid. When something says I'm not worthy, point to that empty grave. Just like Lazarus, oh, you brought me back to life.
No longer
I who live, but Christ in me. For I've been born again, my heart is free. The hope of heaven before me, the grave behind. Hallelujah, you brought me back to life.
Come on, lift your hands and sing.
How can I begin to thank you for all that you've done for me? Jesus, to fully praise you, it will take all eternity. Just like Lazarus, oh, you brought me back to life. Oh, you brought me back to life. Oh, you brought me back to life. Hey, yeah.
longer I who,
but Christ in me,
but Christ in me. For I've been born again,
my heart
is free. The hope of heaven before me, the grave behind. Hallelujah,
you brought me back to life. No longer, no longer I who live,
but Christ in me. For I've been born again, my heart is free. The hope of heaven before me, the grave behind. Hallelujah, you brought me back to life.
Oh, you brought me back to life. Come on, just lift your hands in the sanctuary. We thank you, God, for our freedom. We thank you for the love that you've given us, the forgiveness, oh God, the mercy. We breathe in your presence. Today is a new day. Oh, you brought me back to life. Thank you, Heavenly Father, that every time we gather together in your name, there you are. There you will meet us. You meet us where we gather, and you dwell in the sanctuary, and our praises lift you higher and higher above all else. And we give you this very brand new week, God. We give you the first. This is the first day of a brand new week, oh God. And so we just give it to you. We surrender in your holy presence. Have your way in our hearts. Have your way in this place. Have your way in this city. Have your way in this country, oh God. You reign. You reign. In Jesus' name. And the church said, amen and amen. God bless you, Covenant Church.
Amen and amen. Good morning, everyone. It's good to see you all. And I guess there's only one person here today. Good morning, everyone. Oh, God is so good. I assume you saw all the balloons and the tables out there. Today is called Get in the Game Day. And so I have a few footballs up here. Maybe if you catch this one, this is what you're supposed to be doing. Huh? Do you dare catch? You dare? Get in the game. You ready? You ready? Oh, you missed it. Get that, Ishmael. I won't look at him. Huh? Oh, that was cool. Ready? Touchdown, you got it. Huh? Here's another one. One more. Ready? Woo! Good catch. So, you'll see, out there in the lobby, we have operations, we have media and audio, we have men's ministry, ushers and greeters, security, children's ministry, youth, pretty committee, lots of places for you to serve and get in the game. Amen. You know, it's one thing to be in the stands. It's another thing to get on the field. Yes. And we need some more of you to get on the field. Praise the Lord. Amen. Amen? So we're inviting you today to get on the field. And maybe your next step is to go to our Discover Covenant new members class and really get connected and find out more about Covenant. Amen. And find out where you fit in Covenant, or maybe it's just to get out there and sign up and get in the game. Yes. Amen?
Amen.
Not only is it Get in the Game, it's our legacy launch. In March, at the end of March, we'll be receiving our legacy offering. Our legacy offering is three legs: next generation, kingdom expansion, and missions outreach. It's where we really push to say, we want to leave this church a better place for the next generation. We want to grow, we want to build, and we don't want to leave it worse, we want to leave it better. And the way we leave it better is by giving of our time and our talent. And so I just wanted to throw that out there. The Lord put a word in my heart when Pastor Joe said, we said all of January was really casting vision, and we were like, we've talked about faith and trust. Pastor Joe did last week, and Deanna spoke on no vision, no hope. Without vision, people perish. And I want to try to tie some things in together today on not just vision, but where we are as a church and what I see and what I want to declare this year for 2023. So this will be the culmination of our vision series, the end of our vision series, but we're going to keep on dreaming, keep on having vision for the future. And so there's vision in the battle. There's testing in the vision. If you think God's going to give you vision and there's not going to be a trial that goes along with it or a battle that's going to come along with it, you're in for a big surprise. Because when God plants a vision in you and he shares with you what he sees and what he sees he can do in you and through you and through Covenant Church, then you can bet your bottom dollar that there's going to be some testing that goes with that. Amen? So, you know, in the Old Testament, God revealed himself in dreams and in visions. He showed himself to Jacob in a dream, descending and ascending from heaven. He showed himself to Samuel in a dream. And Samuel said, "Here I am, Lord, speak to me." Even to Pharaoh. He gave Pharaoh dreams, and when it was interpreted, there were 7 years of plenty and 7 years of famine. He was setting them up. He was teaching them. He was showing them, this is what I'm going to do. This is what I can do. And if you'll just listen to me, if you'll listen to my voice, I'll be able to show you so that you can see what I can do in you and through you. There's many times we often are distracted, and the reason why we often don't see what God wants us to see and what he wants to do through us is because we're distracted by other voices. We're listening to other voices, and we're distracted by the things of this life, the cares of life. And life happens. Things happen with our health, things happen with our finances, things happen with our family, our relationships, whatever's going on. But more often than not, that is a distraction, and we get our eyes on what's happening instead of what he wants us to see that's going to happen. All through Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, you hear them talking about Jesus and telling the life of Christ and how he was born, and then he died, and rose again. And we see his life come about through the Gospels. I believe that one of the reasons Jesus came and walked with us, because he could have done it in so many different ways, but the reason why he came and walked with man is because he wanted to show them, he wanted them to emulate what he was doing. He said, this is how I'm living my life. I want you to live your life this way. And he wasn't just walking with them. He was sharing the present with them and speaking their future, speaking our future. John 14:11-13 says, believe me when I say that I am in the Father and the Father is in me, or at least believe on the evidence of the works themselves. Very truly I tell you, here it goes. Whoever believes in me will do works, will do the works I have been doing, and they will do even greater things than these. Let me repeat that. Whoever believes in me will do the works I have been doing, and they will do even greater things than these. Because I am going to the Father. Number one. Point number one. He talked the talk and walked the walk that he wanted them to emulate. Sometimes our doubts, our fears, the distractions, the voices, it has dumbed down church. It has dumbed down what we really believe God can do. After all, we have seen him save because you're here today. We have seen him heal. I am living proof. We have seen him deliver and set free people from addictions. So what is it in us that causes us to doubt that he will do it again, or doubt that there could ever be a day of Pentecost again? And I will do whatever you ask in my name, so that the Father may be glorified in the Son. You see, he was building a reputation for the glory of God. Sometimes we pray as if the answer depends on us. We lay hands on the sick and we pray because maybe we'll get a little credit and get a little glory. Can I tell you something? That if you will step aside and allow God to have all the glory, that he can do more through you and in you than you could ever possibly imagine. If you'll let the ego get out of the way. Because he said, whoever believes. Are you a believer? I'm a believer. So what is it that's keeping us from having that day of Pentecost experience? The answer, you see, is dependent on him. So what do I see in 2023 at Covenant? What do I have the courage to declare? Because there's a lot of things that I can see. But sometimes it's a little more difficult to declare them. And I think they have this picture in media too as well. About 15 years ago, sitting in a hotel, I drew this up on a computer, not knowing that God was going to place us here on this property. You can almost see exactly what building we're in. But there's so much more that God wants to do here. And it's not just about buildings. It's about saving souls. It's about reaching people that are lost, people that are addicted, people that need freedom. So we can look at this picture and we can say, oh, cute, nice. But we have to imagine what God was dropping into our spirits 15 years ago when we went down to pray on that CVS property and believe God for something so much bigger than us, something that only he could do. That we could bring about. And so in Acts, we read in Acts 1, he says, and being assembled together. So we, here we are this morning, we're assembled together. With them, he commanded them not to depart from Jerusalem, but to wait for the promise of the Father, which he said, you have heard from me, for John truly baptized with the Holy Spirit. John truly baptized with water, but you shall be baptized with the Holy Spirit not many days from now. Therefore, when they had come together, they asked him, saying, Lord, will you at this time restore the kingdom to Israel? And he said to them, it is not for you to know times or seasons which the Father has put in his own authority. But here's the kicker. You shall receive the power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you, and you shall be witnesses. He didn't say he was just going to fill you with the Holy Spirit. He said he's going to fill you with the Holy Spirit for a purpose. What's the purpose? To be a witness. To me in Jerusalem and in all of Judea and Samaria and to the end of the earth. You know, the Holy Spirit has gotten really a bad rap. Because back in the 70s and 80s, they had a movement called The Way. And they would all get together. And as a youth group, we decided, let's go see what they're doing. And they would get in a circle, and then they would pray, and they would declare things. But then they would try to teach you how to receive the Holy Spirit and teach you how to speak in tongues. There was nothing anointed about it. But it became a movement that people said, they're just a bunch of quacks, and this is crazy. And so what God was doing was trying to wake America up, but there were individuals, just like the man in the New Testament, that said, can I buy what you're doing? Let me pay you so I can do what you're doing, Jesus. You see, the Holy Spirit can't be bought. It can't be taught. It can only be received. It is a gift from God. Now, when he had spoken these things while they watched, he was taken up, and a cloud received him out of their sight. And while they spoke, looked steadfastly toward heaven, as he went up, behold, two men stood by them in white apparel, who also said, men of Galilee, why do you stand gazing into heaven? Now here they had walked with Jesus for so long. They had seen him do miracle after miracle, and he told them exactly what was going to happen. But yet when it happened and he went into heaven, they just stood there like dumbfounded. Like, you really going to do what you said you're going to do? You took off? You're leaving us here? Are you just gazing? This same Jesus who was taken up from you into heaven will so come in like manner as you saw him go into heaven. Amen. So what happens? Now all these people get together because he's going to tell them what to do. They're going to go have a prayer meeting. Anybody ever been to a prayer meeting? How about prayer service? That's what we call them now. Amen. Right? It's a prayer service. Then they returned to Jerusalem from the mount called Olivet, which is near Jerusalem, a Sabbath day's journey. And when they had entered, they went up into the upper room where they were staying, Peter, James, John, Andrew, Philip, and the son of Alphaeus, and Simon the Zealot, and Judas the son of James. They all continued with one accord in prayer and supplication with the women and Mary, the mother of Jesus, and with his brothers. I think there's something to be said about being in one accord. That is really the reason why we ask people to take or to go to Discover Covenant class. Yes. And the reason why we do that is because the only way we can be in one accord and share vision is if we all are on the same page. Amen? Amen? So if you know what I know, and I know what you know, and we're all moving in the same direction, it's like a train moving, and it's just chugging right along, and we can get where we're going, and God can do what he wants to do through us and in us if we'll allow ourselves to become in one accord. Amen. Amen? Every song that they sang today, Ezekiel's prayer, being in one accord, being in unity, it all went hand in hand. And as I was standing there on the front row, I couldn't help but begin to weep, because I know what the Holy Spirit poured into me. And I said, Lord, I can't declare these things this morning. And he said, yes, you can, because I am declaring them through you. And I said, okay, God, I want only the Holy Spirit to speak through me. Let every word that comes out of my mouth be driven by you, God, because it's not me standing up here today declaring your word. It is you. It is the Holy Spirit that is within me. And so now I say to you, I am believing God for a day of Pentecost in Lake Havasu City, where the roof shakes. There is a sound from heaven that comes so suddenly that it shakes this city. It shakes us to the core. What are you believing God for? I believe it's going to happen. I believe it's going to happen this year in 2023. Yeah. Amen. So when the day of Pentecost had fully come, you know, the day of Pentecost is 50 days after Easter. That's May 20th, 28th, I believe. That's when we celebrate it anyway. I threw that in there last night because I got to tell you, I am craving more of Him than I ever have before. I am wanting Him to wake us up. We are living in a day where people don't know up is down and down is up and right is left and left is right. And the only thing that's going to fix that is the move of the Holy Spirit. They were all with one accord in one place. And suddenly, there came a sound from heaven as of a rushing mighty wind. And it filled the whole house where they were sitting. Then there appeared to them divided tongues as a fire, and one sat upon each of them. And they were all filled with the Holy Spirit. Not just some. All were filled. And began to speak with other tongues as the Spirit gave them utterance. And they were dwelling in Jerusalem, Jews and devout men from every nation under heaven. And when this sound occurred, the multitude came together. Lake Havasu City came together. And were confused because everyone heard them speak in his own language. Then they were all amazed and marveled, saying to one another, "Look, are not all these who speak Galileans? And how is it that we hear each in our own language in which we have been born? We hear them speaking in our own tongues, the wonderful works of God." So they were all amazed and perplexed, saying to one another, "Whatever could this mean?" What does it mean to you? Then there were others mocking. Said they are full of new wine. They're drunk. Call me crazy. Call me drunk. Call me a zealot for Jesus. Call me anything you want. But I'm all in. I'm all in. So when I got to reading the scripture, Stan, the next part of it, I started replacing the words. It said, "But Peter stood up, standing up with the 11, raised his voice and said to them." And then I said, "Well, no, let's change that." Then Pastor Joe, standing up, said, raised his voice and said to them. Why not? "Men of Judea and all who dwell in Jerusalem, women, ladies and gentlemen of Covenant Church in all of Lake Havasu City. Amen. Let this be known to you and heed my words. We are not drunk. Amen. It is only the third hour of the day, but this is what was spoken by the prophet Joel." How did Peter know what the prophet Joel had prophesied? Holy Spirit? Maybe he had heard Jesus talking about it over and over and over again. You see, we like to hear all about the good works and the miracles, and we like to hear how wonderful life is, and we like to hear about how we're going to be blessed, and we like to hear the messages of prosperity and the messages of healing, but something had to take place before that ever happened. Something had to take place before that ever happened. They didn't have the power of the Holy Spirit. So how did Jesus do all of that? Because he was God in flesh, dwelling among us. "And it shall come to pass in the last days, says God, that I will pour out of my Spirit on all flesh. Your sons and your daughters shall prophesy. Your young men shall see visions, and your old men shall dream dreams." I am calling and declaring it right now that we have men and women in this house that are gonna see visions and dream dreams. Amen. The Holy Spirit will lead and guide us. And without the Holy Spirit, we are being led by our own ambitions and our own cravings. I see and I declare in 2023, a day of Pentecost where Lake Havasu City Covenant Church is in one accord, in one place, and suddenly there comes a sound from heaven as of a rushing mighty wind, and it will fill this house.
Amen?
I also declare that we're going to see the birth of 25 life groups this year in 2023. 50 leaders equipped for the kingdom. Filled children's rooms with more than enough children's workers. Vibrant youth ministry reaching the teenagers of our city. Mission partners in Mexico and Botswana and other countries. Provision for a full-time youth and children's pastor. Hundreds of water baptisms. Are you with me? Are you ready for the ride? Worship team expansion. Live stream expansion. A packed house 4 times on Sunday. Yeah, it's going to wear us out, but I'm ready. Are you ready? You say, oh, Pastor Rhonda, the first service is not even half full yet. Oh, honey, buckle your seatbelts. I see 150,000 coming in for kingdom expansion and building in, for our building fund so that we can build that new sanctuary. Pay down debt. How do we get there, Pastor Rhonda? Oh, I'm so glad you asked. So glad you asked. Let's see how it happened for the first church on the day of Pentecost. Then Peter said to them, repent. And let every one of you be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of your sins. And ye shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. Amen. For the promise is to you and to your children and to all that are afar off, even as many as the Lord our God shall call. So it's not just for you, it's for your children and the next generation and the next generation. We have got to leave a legacy that cannot be forgotten. We are here today because Peter stood up and preached the word of God to a multitude in a city, and that is why we are able to come together today and do what we do and worship the God that we worship. And with many other words, he testified and exhorted them, saying, be saved from this perverse generation. I would say that today we are seeing a very perverse generation. I would say today is the day where we really need to stand up and ask the Holy Spirit to fill us so full that only he can be seen and not our own agendas and our own ambitions and our own egos. And with many other words, he testified. Are you testifying? Then those who gladly received his word, gladly, were baptized. And that day, about 3,000 souls were added to them, and they continued steadfastly. Just because they got an addition of 3,000, they didn't stop. They kept going. They continued steadfastly. And they went from house to house breaking bread. Yes. Wow, that's life groups right there. Yes. Did anybody get a football saying lead a life group? Oh, Ishmael. Oh, yeah. Life groups right here. Amen. Praising God and having favor with all the people. And the Lord added to the church daily those who were being saved. I want God to use me in such a way that souls are added to the church daily, such as should be saved, and the worship team can come. I want to see this altar filled with people receiving Christ. I want to see this baptism tank. I met with Larry McGraw yesterday, and I said, I want you to take out this ramp, and I want you to take our baptism tank, and I want you to install our baptism tank over here, and we're going to have baptisms on Sundays, and we're going to do it every Sunday, and we're going to make it available every Sunday so that when somebody walks through that door, they can be baptized whenever they want. Amen. Amen. I'm tired of rolling that baptismal tank out here and saying, oh, we're going to have baptism Wednesday. No, I want it to be such as should be saved that when they walk through that door and they say, I need to be water baptized, Pastor Joe, Pastor Rhonda, Pastor Jay, they can get in the water. starting April 1st, will be our first Sunday, the first Sunday of the month. We're going to start communion on April, on the first Sunday in April.
Amen.
We've been doing it the first Wednesday of the month. The Holy Spirit said to get everybody in unity and one accord, you need to take another step. I know that God is doing something big. I can see it when I'm in prayer. I can see it in my dreams. I can feel it from the very core of my being. Would you stand with me? As you bow your heads, you may be thinking, Pastor Rana, you've gone plumb crazy. Or maybe you're standing there and you have this deep yearning that you want to experience the Holy Spirit in such a way that you can see through the eyes of the Spirit what God wants to do in you and through you. You see, He doesn't just fill you with the Holy Ghost for you. He said He fills you with the Holy Spirit so that you can be a witness, so that you can have that power from on high and see things through the eyes of the Spirit. See what He's doing and what He wants to do. He wants to take you to a place that you've never been. He wants to do something in you and through you that you've never experienced. But you have to say, more of you and less of me, God. I want more of you, Lord. Decrease me and increase you. Are you willing to let Him allow Him to increase Himself in you so that you are just a vessel carrying Him and being a witness in this city, on this earth? You know, I didn't read the part in Acts where they were so overcome by the Holy Spirit that they sold everything that they had and came together to do what was needed. I told Pastor Joe, if that's what it takes for us, for he and I to see a day of Pentecost, then sell it all, because I want God to do something that I have been yearning for a very long time. Why not? Why not see a move of the Holy Spirit that changes our school system here in Lake Havasu City, that will save our children and save our teenagers? It will save the next generation. Yeah, I've been on that soapbox for a long time. I'm not getting off of it until I see God do something. I declare that we will reach the children and the teenagers of our city. Holy Spirit, if you're in this room today, and you want God to move in you and through you like you've never experienced before, just raise your hand. I'm going to pray for you that the Holy Spirit will just, the breath of God will breathe on you life like you have never known. Thank you for those hands. Thank you for those hands. Heavenly Father, right now, breathe on us your Holy Spirit. Breath of God, breathe us, breathe into us life, earth, into our families. Father, fill us with your Holy Spirit. Right now, we yearn for you. We long for you. Come, visit us. Let us be in your presence, Father. Fill this place with your Holy Spirit. So much so that as people drive by this property, they will be drawn into this place. That they will feel the Holy Spirit tugging them as they turn their cars into the parking lot, as they walk onto the property. Let your Holy Spirit cover this city. Breathe on us.
Holy
Breathe
Spirit,
into us right
you
now.
Are welcome here. Come flood this place and fill the atmosphere. Your glory, God, is what our hearts long for. To be overcome by your presence, Lord. Holy Spirit, you are welcome here. Come flood this place and fill the atmosphere. Your glory, God, is what our hearts long for. To be overcome by your presence, Lord.
You can either stay in the bleachers or get in the game. Get on the field. I choose to be in the game. I love you all.
Amen, amen, amen. Come on, come on. Come on. You know, you can sit there and you can take that word in two different ways. You can sit there and take that word and say, she's crazy. I don't know what got into her, but she's crazy, and there's no way that what she is seeing can happen in my time. Amen? Or you can sit there and say, you know what? I'm going to believe that God can do some crazy things, and I'm going to have some crazy faith to believe that what the Holy Spirit put on her heart can be done and will be done in Jesus' name. Come on, Covenant Church. If you believe and you have crazy faith, that he can do more than we can. Come on, make some noise in Covenant Church on Sunday morning. Woo! Amen, amen, amen. Now it's time for you to take that step. How do you eat an elephant? Start with the trunk. No, one bite at a time. Right? One bite at a time. So now today, what a timely word. This is Get in the Game Sunday. Some of y'all looking at me like, why are y'all wearing a Dallas Cowboys shirt? They gone. There's a special spot out in the parking lot for you. Some of you, I mean, there's a guy with a Raiders hoodie on in here. There's a Denver Broncos. There's a Seattle. It's Get in the Game Sunday, right? So that means you're spiritual life, your salvation is not a spectator sport. You can choose to sit there and ride the pine and watch everyone else do the work, or you can get in the game, make a move, take a step, get up and say, I want to be counted, I want to be heard, I want to be part of what's going on. And right down as you walk out these doors, there is tables on either side of you, on both ends of both exits, down the hallway of different ministries that need help, that need people to volunteer and serve, of different small groups that are looking to grow and expand, of different places that you can be a leader and be part of this. You can, hey, we all need to sit on the bench sometimes and just take a break and watch what's going on so I can gather my stuff and figure out what I need to do. But some of us, it's time to get up and say, put me in, coach. Put me in, coach. I'm ready. So now's your opportunity. As you walk out there, don't just pass those tables that are out there. Don't just look at that crazy Cowboys fan and say, what are you doing out there? Say, I want to be part of men's ministry. I want to be part of the life groups that are going on. I want to be part of the worship team. I want to be part of media or ushers and greeters or secure. What? There's 15 different places out here that you can volunteer, sign up, get to know us, get to know what we're doing, and be part of the game. Come on, Covenant Church. If you want to get in the game this Sunday, it is your chance and your opportunity. Amen. Amen. There's a bunch of other stuff here, but I think that's the most important thing that we can do right now this morning. Amen. We got our women's conference coming up in a couple weeks. Come on. There you go. Woo. It's like the sun came out behind me and lit you all up. Amen. Amen. We got a lot of things coming up, and I'm excited to have it. Let's all, before we leave, let's all receive the blessing together. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. May the Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace, and may he cover you with his name, Jesus. Come on, Covenant Church, let's get in the game today. Amen.
Lie number one, you're supposed to have it all together. And when they ask how you're doing, just smile and tell them never better.